Welcome back to another episode of the Switch Survival Guide. On the last episode, we tried to tame this Parasaur and hit it in the head a few too many times. Yeah, that happened. Moving on. So, today we are going to try to tame this Parasaur and see if we can redeem ourselves. So, we immediately broke our slingshot too, which is great. We're also going to teach you how to ride a Parasaur and all the reasons a Parasaur is so helpful. So here we are, right where we left off on the last episode, and we have this other Parasaur that I'm going to pull out my Bola and use the bottom right trigger to throw it and completely incapacitate the Parasaur. Now I'm immediately going to pull out my slingshot and break it. So this is why we brought two slingshots and put them both in the hotbar. I was immediately able to switch to the one that wasn't broken. Now I'm hitting it in the body instead of the head because this is a lower level Parasaur, and headshots do more damage. They also knock it out more quickly, but it's also a better chance of killing it because they do more physical damage to it. So these body shots will hopefully knock it out just like that. Now I'm going to hit the Y button to open up his inventory, and then I will put the cursor over the berries I want to feed him, and then hold down the B button to drop the entire stack into his inventory. Once again, we're using Mejo berries instead of any other berries because those are more effective, and he's already taming up nicely. Now I'm repairing my slingshot, which once again, as long as I've got the materials for it, I just had to hit the button on my hotbar where that slingshot is, and that will use up the materials and repair that slingshot instead of having to make a whole new one. So now I have two working slingshots again. Now I'm gathering all the materials I can because we're probably going to need a lot of berries, and a Parasaur is a lot easier to tame. I just want to check out this water because he's partially in the water, and sharks should not be able to get into water this shallow, but it's possible that rays can. There's manta rays in the water. So I'm going to just kind of keep an eye out for that. I'm also going to check around to make sure there's nothing dangerous around here. But first, I'm going to drop some more Mejo berries into his inventory, and that should be enough for him to eat for now. And check it out, he's already up to 20% taming. Parasaurs tame up pretty quickly. Now I've got some narco berries, which I can use to increase his torpidity and keep him from waking up if it gets too low, but I think we're gonna be in great shape. His taming bar is increasing faster than his torpidity is decreasing. So another great thing about a Parasaur is he makes a great mobile storage bin. So a Parasaur has a lot of weight. It can carry like 400 pounds worth of materials right now, and if we increase its weight stat as he levels up, he'll be able to carry even more. So Parasaurs are great pack animals. Now you can see I'm encumbered because I'm carrying so much wood, which is quite heavy. It's almost as heavy as stone. So I'm just going to open up his inventory with Y, and then hold down the B button to drop entire stacks of wood. And now he has 82 weight out of 489. So I can put a lot of wood on this guy and he can still move just fine. Now, I've got some narcotics, which I can use to keep him unconscious if he starts waking up faster. I also have narco berries, which I would prefer to use because they have a weaker effect, but they're much easier to get your hands on. But I don't think we're going to have to use any because he is taming up quite nicely. Now looking in the distance, there is a Parasaur running around, and every time you see that, that means there's something at least remotely dangerous down that direction. It's probably just a Dilophosaur attacking it, but we'll keep an eye out just in case. Always be aware of your surroundings because other dinosaurs can kill your tamed dinosaurs. So I'm just going to check out my inventory here and see how we're doing as far as learning the stuff that I want to learn. And we can now learn the Parasaur saddle, which is the main thing that I wanted to get before I actually tamed a Parasaur. They're much more helpful when you can actually ride them. Now, before you can ride one, they're still a good mobile storage bin. They're a great pack mule, and you can load them up with items, make them follow you, and just collect a bunch of stuff out in the field and bring it back to your house easily. Oh, this is going to tame up quite nicely. Now, the Parasaur saddle that I just made is a little bit heavy, but I'm just going to drop off some more of this heavy stuff here. I still don't want to put the saddle in the Parasaur's inventory because if he runs off, it actually takes a lot of hide to make that saddle, and that's one of the harder things to get my hands on. Now, even though I don't really need to do this, I'm just going to show you, if I put a Narco Berry into his inventory by double tapping the B button, it'll put just one berry in, and then I can hover over it and hit the right trigger, which will actually make him eat that Narco Berry and increase his torpidity, so he won't wake up. So I'm just going to continue collecting materials while he is taming, and he'll tame up pretty darn quickly. But in the next episode or two, I'm actually going to start building a better house, which will be much better protected. So I want to get a bunch of wood, thatch, and fiber so that we can actually make some more materials. And we're just about to unlock being able to build wooden foundations and ceilings and all that stuff, which is much, much better than thatch. So he should be taming up any second now. There you go. Okay. Now, this is a female. I specifically went for females. Sorry, I keep saying he. And I'm going to name her Mint because she's a nice mint green color. I actually like the look of this one much better. And she's already leveled up to level 13, which is great. So you can see here her health is only about a third of her health left because we actually did a lot of damage when we hit her with those slingshots. So we're going to try to keep her out of trouble for a little while. But yeah, look at that cool Parasaur. So I can tell her to follow me. I've still got my ordering group selected to one, but even so, if I directly point at her and say follow one or stop one, it will still control her to do that. So I'm going to bring her back over to my base where we have just a tiny bit of protection. These Dilophosaurs still can't protect us very well, but they're doing something. So I'm going to hit the Y button to open up my inventory, and then if I hit the bottom right trigger on the saddle, it will actually equip the saddle. You can also select it and then move it over there. So when I come up and hit the X button, I jump onto the back of this Parasaur, and you can see we can walk around now. Now, if we get attacked by something, the Parasaur takes damage instead of me when I'm on its back, which is very helpful. We can also click down on the left stick to run, just like we can normally, and the Parasaur actually moves really fast and has a lot more stamina than us. Now, I'm going to go ahead and harvest this Parasaur because it's got a lot of hide. They're actually great for getting meat and hide, and we broke something else. So I'm holding down the button for my hatchet, and you can see what we're missing. And I've actually got all those materials on the Parasaur, which is really handy. So now we can just make that hatchet again and then drop the materials back on the Parasaur. And you can see he's still got plenty more weight left that he can carry. So they're very helpful for that. Now, if we want to go hunting and we have a bow and arrow, which I think is going to be the episode right after this, I'll show you how to do this, you can actually fire a bow and arrow off the back of a Parasaur, which is very helpful. So, and I'm going to tell him to stop and just sit here for a minute. Now, another cool thing about a Parasaur is he has an alert setting. So if we tell him to be alerted to creatures, since we're on a PvE server, we're not going to need to worry about players. So I'm going to set her to creatures only. Now, if a dangerous dinosaur comes around, like say a velociraptor comes down the coast, once it gets within a certain range, she is actually going to make a loud noise and let me know that there's a dangerous dinosaur around. So that's another very helpful thing that they recently added to Parasaurs. Now, Parasaurs can also swim very quickly, so that's just another nice bonus. So, thanks for watching, and in the next episode, we'll show you how to hunt on the back of a Parasaur. Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.